Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Today, I'm going to walk you through the really simple process of replacing a thermostat and a diaphragm on a Mercury Tracker 40 horsepower. Pretty simple to do, and what I'm actually doing right now is transferring it from an old block to a complete engine build that we did. So, let me go grab my tools and we'll dive into this project. Now what we're going to be replacing behind that cover is the diaphragm, the thermostat, the associated O-ring gasket with it, and then the outer gasket. Now, like I said, for this particular setup, we're transferring it from an old block to an engine build. Now, if you want to see that happen, why don't you check out this unit's playlist and I can walk you through the procedure of what it took to rebuild this block. Now, to remove it, it's really simple. You just need a 13 millimeter socket, and we're going to take off these four bolts. Because all we're really after here is the cover itself, a spring, and then the mount that the diaphragm goes on. Now, one of the telltale signs of a thermostat that's either stopped up or not functioning at all is either A, it's overheating, or B, it's not coming up to a good running temperature and probably fouling out your spark plugs. So that could be an indicator that your thermostat is not functioning as it should. All right. There's your housing, your spring, the diaphragm. This was your old thermostat. And look at that one. I would imagine that it was not flowing very well because that looks pretty rough. Now what we need to do is remove this end cap from the diaphragm. Take that apart. Take the old diaphragm off. Install the new one. And that's just a Phillips head screw that's doing this. And when you start it back on, keep in mind that this is just nylon. So you want to make sure you get it started in the threads and not creating new ones. If it's got too much tension, back it off and then bring it in. Now it's just going to be reverse of what we did to pull it apart. Diaphragm in first. All right, guys, we've got a spring in place. We're going to go ahead and put our thermostat in the housing first. We've got our bolts in place. Then we're going to put our gasket. I know this is a little tricky, but this is the best way to do it. Now, hold all that together. There we go. Just bring your bolts in finger tight. Now, you should be able to just push with your hand to get it to go flush. And if you can't, that means that your thermostat isn't aligned like it should be. The trick is to have the gasket in place on top of it, holding it into the cover itself. Because if you try to do it the other way, it's going to pinch the gasket and not seal up properly. There, we've got it. Everything looks good. Let's go ahead and tighten these down. Now we're going to torque these to 16.5. Well, all right, guys, there you go. That's going to wrap up this particular video. Well, listen, if you need any parts for your boat, why don't you come see us at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. And hey, if you like what you see, why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button? That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on next. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net. We will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.